Well, hey guys, I have some sad news. The sad news is we got a new microphone, but we're struggling to use it. So throughout this video, it's going to get kind of, the audio is not going to be that great, but bear with us because there's still some fun stuff in it. So Vin's out. Here he comes. He is robing up in my robe.
Why don't you let the people be surprised?
Because it's taking you forever to get here, so they're wondering what is going... You look so weird. Do I look like that when I wear it? Oh my gosh. We're going to reference this robe later on in the video. God, why do you look so weird? This is what I look like, only I'm not brown. All right, that's it, guys.
I'm Vin.
I'm sorry.
And it is 12:55 a.m. Eastern Standard Time.
We have had more technical difficulties since we spoke to you last on main stage show.
Oh my gosh. They don't even know what you're talking about. That's how late it is. Oh. So one of the things that we wanted to figure out was, what are we going to call? So we know we have the underground show, which this is the underground show. And what about the earlier show? Yeah.
It was prime time.
I called it prime time. Prime time is just not very rock and roll.
No.
Not very. You don't feel like a badass when you say
no,
prime
not
time.
At all.
And it's just not rock and roll. And so, of course, we went to the village. We said, "Yo, what do we name this?" And somebody came up with the most awesome name for the show. So the name of the early show is going to be
Main Stage.
Main Stage. We have main stage and we have underground. It's legit.
What I was just thinking. I was like, it's legit is legit. What I was thinking in my head.
We're the most legit channel ever. Yeah, we're so legit we can't even deliver on our promises.
Good
night.
I know.
We're going to give you two videos a day. One at, 5 and one at 11.
It's technically another day now because it's 1 a.m.
Hopefully they'll forgive us for sucking as horribly as we do. Look, it's only been a month and 4 or 5 days, right? So,
right.
You guys have been extremely patient with us, and we thank you for that. By the way, I have to say, now I'm not even going to talk about that, because it's just, I mean, should I? I'm going to talk about it. So, we hit 2,000 subs on Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
Sunday at 9 o'clock, I posted, "Hey, we hit 2,000 subs." And then we were in a store. Buying certain things.
Oh.
And I looked at our thing because I'm looking at this thing probably 14 times a day. 1,000 times a day. And we hit 3,000 subs a couple hours ago.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, it's taking less and less time for us to accumulate. I mean, hitting 2,000 and on a Sunday and then hitting 3,000 on a Thursday.
Yeah.
Ridiculous. Thank you. It's ridiculous. You guys are amazing. You're the most amazing community. And you know, I want to tell you guys something. One of the things that I've seen is people will post very long comments and then like in the middle they'll say, "I'm sorry, I'm rambling." You are not rambling. We freaking stay on these things for freaking 30, 40 minutes.
You write Should we also apologize?
Yeah, yeah.
Sorry for rambling, guys. This video is probably going to be 30 minutes.
Yeah, so you suffer through 30 minutes of us, and then you take the time to actually sit down and write a very thought-out response. I mean, I am honored when I see a very thought-out response.
I'm like, "Vin, read it to me."
Yeah, yeah, yeah. She'll say, like, "Hey, read me this thing here." So, guys, if you post a long... Don't ever apologize for that. I think that that's... You know, I'm going to go ahead and brag, and I'll say I go to other channels. I don't see big, long responses like that. You know, our folks are, like, thinking and investing in what we're trying to accomplish, because everything about the village, everything about what we're trying to accomplish is about, let's hear where you're coming from. You know, you're chilling with the devil, like you're hanging out with Satan. Okay, talk to me about it.
Right.
You don't believe, "Oh, you idiot, there's no such thing as Satan. I'm an atheist." Okay, talk to me about it. Hey, actually, you're not real. You know, I want to hear everything. We want to hear everything. This is an environment where everybody, and for the most part, 98% of us have been very respectful to one another.
Definitely.
I love that.
Definitely.
98%. The other 2%, you know, go to another village. In this village, we love each other. We respect each other.
Right.
But, you know, everybody's views are up for grabs. Everybody's views are up for grabs, including ours. Okay, now. Now that we get that out of the way, we love you guys. Mwah. I mean, it's the underground show, so you guys have nothing better to do. We're going to post this at 2 o'clock in the morning, so. We are going to do Ghost Square Hammer. I got a guy, I forgot his name, God forgive me. He posts it and he'll say attempt number one.
Really?
Yeah, he'll post it on the page. Cute. Now I can tell that you're not. He'll say attempt number one, then attempt number two. And like today he was like attempt number three. Look at this, babe. Look, I'll try to show you real quick if I can show you. Cute. He goes, attempt number one. And it's like, you know me, like stuff doesn't really affect me.
Uh-huh.
But I kind of feel like a little pressure. I'm like, oh man. You know, and
well,
it's
he knew what he was doing.
Yeah, he knows what he's doing. And I'm looking because I want to find this guy's name because he deserves it because that was a brilliant strategy. You know how I am. I love really good strategy.
Uh-huh.
Where is it? We've probably lost all of our. We're probably going to get like 4 views on this thing, on this video. Yeah, 42 if you watch this thing to the end. I shouldn't have said that.
I should have said that.
Paul G. Bells, I think his name is. Please react to Ghost Square Hammer attempt number 3. Yes, continue. I just created the shortlist. They're on it. Anyway, so shout out to the big homie. Good job. Way to be persistent, and that's why we tell you guys to go to the village.
Mm-hmm.
Because stuff like that happens, you know? Look, you see how big our comment streams are? So, I mean, it's hard to keep track of it, but if you're in the village, It's much smaller, it's much more concentrated, and we're much more likely to hear what you have to say. All right. Way too long of an introduction. This is Square Hammer Ghost, the lyric video. Let's do it. You ready to rock and roll, babe?
I'm ready.
All right. Are you serious?
Not what I expected.
Is that the band?
I don't know.
I was not expecting this.
No.
Destin, undercover secret. We'll be right back. that's the song was over.
But it was still doing the ending of the music part.
No, no. She's just, that was just her little commercial for herself. You know, that made with Adobe Spark, blah, 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 blah.
Yeah,
blah.
But it was still playing the ending of the song.
Okay, I'm not having this argument.
See? There was a little bit more.
No, she added that. Whoever edited that video, babe, added that.
I don't believe you. Post in the comments if he's right or not. I don't think he's right. I think that was the ending of the song.
Your Grace, they're always going to agree with you.
Stop that. They always agree with you. That's because I'm right.
No, it's because you're extremely beautiful.
That's not why they're agreeing.
I do the analytics every day. Believe me. If 98% of our audience was female, they'd be agreeing with me all the time. They said the Opeth song was good. That should show you that there's some bias there.
Oh, my gosh.
All right, so this completely surprised me. The name of the band was Ghost. I thought we were going to get some death metal.
I thought we were going to get something kind of eerie.
You know, I thought, you know, what's that show? Grease?
Yeah.
It seemed like a song you'd find in Grease. You know, you put a little quarter in the jukebox. But then they're singing about the devil. Do you swear to the devil?
Like, are you on point? Like, are you on with the devil? Are
you swear with the devil? Hell no,
I'm swearing with the devil. The hell's wrong with you?
What's your problem?
But it kind of sounded...
This song to me was scarier than the Behemoth song.
Because it was a freaking trap.
Yeah, it was
like
a trap.
Happy thing. Like, hey, is everybody good? We're all on board with the devil?
Yeah, yeah. My man Nergal, I think is his name. Or Negral. Somebody's going to show. Actually, his name is Nerahovamu Mephisto or whatever. I know. I mispronounced it. But, like, at least he's like, hey, you know, I'm right. The devil. Hell, Satan, you know? No. But these guys are like, everybody's going to drop it to hell.
As I'm closing in, imposing on your slumber.
Yeah.
You call on me as bells begin to chime.
No.
That's mad creepy, no. Yo.
that's not a very good... A lot of good situation.
You remember on Scrooge? Remember that old movie, Scrooge? What was the name of it? You remember the guy...
The name of the movie was Scrooge?
No, the story was about Scrooge, but I don't remember what the name it was.
The Christmas story?
Yeah, the Christmas one where the ghost of Christmas past and all the ghosts would come and the bell would chime Scrooge, first.
Yeah.
A Christmas Carol.
A Christmas Carol. Yeah, Christmas Carol.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, and then the bell would chime and then there would be some demon.
Oh, my God.
You know, Muhammad... Sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He would say that bells were like a sign of the jinn, like bad spirits.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he didn't like bells. So, and then you got the Christmas Carol. So, you know, Muhammad and you know, the Christmas Carol both agree that this is not a good song.
It was called Ghost.
This is a shaitan. It's a devil. Yeah. No, Ghost is the name of the band. Square Hammer.
Oh, what a strange name.
Well, you know that Masonic thing down the street, the Korah Temple or whatever? Yeah, so, like, that's a thing, like, because in Freemasonry, it's about building and stuff, so you got the square, and then you got the hammer.
Oh, really?
That's one of their symbols, because it's Masonry, you're building, and blah, 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 and Solomon's dark arts and all this stuff. You know, the Bible does say that Solomon was, like, he was a master of dark arts.
It does?
Yeah, it says that in the Bible.
King Solomon?
Yeah, so that's where
a master of dark arts. No, I don't remember reading that. What book is that in?
It's in First Kings. I'll show you later. Oh, but anyway, that's like the background of the Masonic stuff. So the hammer and the square. So like square hammer. I see what you did there. Like that's like a subliminal, like Masonic, like little thingy.
So then
it says, "Do you swear to the devil?" You swear to the devil.
Which... Is the T in ghost? Can scroll back up. Is the T in Ghost, is that an upside-down cross?
That's an upside-down cross. That's the album. Look at that. Yeah, see, it's an upside-down cross.
But it was so...
And I think that G is, like, something weird, too.
I know, something with that. I know. I was
something
like,
devilish.
What is something devilish.
Probably some devilish letter. Why were you telling me to review this song, bro?
Yeah.
All our conspiracy people are like, I knew it! He was a Mason. No, I'm not no Mason.
No.
But, okay, all right, so go ahead. What do you got? What were we going to say? I'm sorry.
No, I just wanted to know if that was an upside down cross or if that was supposed to look at that square hammer or what.
Yeah. So it says, are you ready to swear right here, right now, before the devil?
Yeah.
You know, when I say Wallahi or she says Wallahi, it basically means I swear to God. You know, you're supposed to swear to God. You're not supposed to swear to the devil.
I've seriously met, believe it or not, multiple people, two or three people in my life that have told me that they swore their soul to the devil. Have you ever met somebody that said that to you?
No.
Yeah, and then like
they Faust, like they sold their soul to the devil.
Yeah, like they were, and I was like, you what? And then they were telling me that they did, and they were like really, really weird. And they said after that, like the creepiest shit was happening around them.
Well, duh.
Well, I know, but it was.
Well, what do you expect?
Well, I know, but it was like.
How does one sell one's soul to the devil?
Well,
like,
I think
what do you say?
No, it was like one of those things where somebody was going to die. They didn't want the person to die. So they were like, if you let this person live, then I swear, like, my soul belongs to you.
Why wouldn't you just call on God to do that? Why would you ask the devil to
Maybe they didn't think that God was going to listen to them, and they figured they had a better shot with... Maybe they already called out to God, and God didn't give them the answer they wanted, so they said, all right, then, I'm going to your enemy. I'm guessing. I don't know.
And then the person got better, so now they owe the devil their soul?
Yeah.
SubhanAllah. That's terrible.
Yeah.
Yeah, I really, I'll tell you something. Like, when I listened to the Behemoth song, I was not creeped out. I was a little sad, but I wasn't creeped out creeped out.
Oh, this one creeps you out?
But this creeps me out. Because
I kept feeling like I was misunderstanding the lyrics because it didn't feel like it matched the song.
The entrance to the shrine, you know, hiding from the light.
Yeah.
Hiding from the light, sacrificing nothing.
And you know, we'll always say like sacrificing is in
it's our meta narrative.
Yeah, exactly.
That's our meta narrative. That's the story we live in is sacrifice.
But so sort of like the, sacrificing nothing. I mean, you just swore yourself to the devil. You're sacrificing something.
Well, what do you mean? He says, are you ready to swear right now before the devil?
Yeah.
Are you on the square? Yeah.
So
yeah.
If they are ready.
Yeah.
Then they're going to sacrifice.
See, right there. Hammering nails into a sacred coffin. See, that's a Masonic ritual. They put you in this coffin.
Stop it.
Wallahi, they put you in this coffin. Bush did this.
What?
I'm telling you.
So what happened?
You need to get up on your... I need to get you up on the conspiracy stuff. No, but this is Yale. Skull and Bone Society.
Yeah?
Yeah. So one of their rituals is they put you in a coffin. Oh. You know, you hang out. They close the coffin over you. I think you're naked in there. And then you come out and you're basically resurrected now as a full-fledged Skull and Bones member.
Stop it. Are you serious?
I'm telling you. Google it. You go on a call, you come out. Look, and you call on me
How long are you in there?
Listen, you call on me for powers clandestine.
What did that word mean again?
Clandestine, it means like secret, like unknown. Like if you're in the CIA, you're like a clandestine operator. You know? So like, this is probably the devil. You know what I mean? Like, or some demon. Like, because you're calling on me for clandestine powers after you come out of this coffin.
I feel like that.
How real is that?
That's scary shit. Yeah, but I think that somebody could listen to this song and not really get, and they're just like going with the music, you know.
What are you talking about?
What?
It says swear to the devil. How would they not know?
I know.
This is because
I felt like I was like moving around.
I was like, no shit. I was like, yeah, hey, it's 1 o'clock, but hey,
I felt like you were turning up the tunes in the car.
Yeah, the bar in the '50s. I mean, they wouldn't serve me any soda, but that's all right. I'm a white girl, good times. but I thought I was like, wait, the devil?
What the devil is this?
I'd much rather talk to Behemoth. These guys are dangerous. These guys, it says right here, right now. It's like, make your decision right now. Like, are you going to do this, like, right now or what? Yeah.
That's crazy.
Yeah, that's pretty crazy. But I think that this is about, like, Freemasonry. We got to do a show on conspiracy theories, man, because that stuff is, like, I'm kind of like, I don't even know what the percentage is, but I do definitely think that there's some, like, truth to it. You know what I mean?
Conspiracies?
Yeah, because,
I never heard you say something like that before.
No, I've said that stuff. I mean, I've said it. I just don't let it dominate my life. Like, I don't try to figure everything out and let it, like, completely rule me. But I do think that there are, you know, societies, secret societies that take part in this stuff. But definitely the coffin thing, man, that's a real thing. That's a real thing. So yeah, there's not a lot of lyricism to this, and the rhymes aren't it's not very clever. Well, the writing is not very clever to me.
No.
But I do think it was clever how they...
The type of music they used to go with it?
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Because I think that if the devil really was behind music, he would be behind this stuff way more than Behemoth. I think the guys in Behemoth are just way too artistically gifted to credit that to the devil. Like, I don't think the devil's that smart. I think, like, this is something the devil would write.
Oh, my gosh.
No, I'm serious.
I know you are.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
Just real basic, real just...
Yeah.
Bleh. You know? But still deceptive because it's, like, very, like, you know, there's no deception with Behemoth.
Mm-hmm.
That's how I know it's not... Behemoth is not really satanic because there's no deception around it. And the main weapon of the devil in the Bible is deception.
Yep. No, you're right.
And so...
Right.
So there was no deception in Behemoth.
Right. It says that he comes as an angel of light.
Right.
He looks good. It's all dancey.
Everybody's
good.
Having a good time.
But it's not.
Everybody's having a good time. And then, you know, next thing you know, you're naked in a coffin. Or dancing around some fire in the Bohemian Grove with an owl.
Nope.
I tell you about that? All these world leaders dancing around butt naked?
Are you serious? World leaders?
Yes, man. Bohemian
that is so
Grove.
Shameful. What
Shout
the
out to the
heck?
Shameful?
Yes.
You don't even care that it's like a conspiracy. All you care about is the shame factor.
Yes.
These people are freaking destroying the planet. All you care, they were naked. They put on clothes before they go and destroy the earth. What's wrong with you? What is your problem?
You're absolute...
I know.
Yes, that's exactly what came to my head.
You are such a disaster. We are doomed. We are doomed, babe. You just want the tyrannical criminals to be clothed.
Just put yourself something
be clothed as you bring the planet into the underworld. Good night.
Oh my god.
Okay, all right. So ghosts.
two for me.
I give you a two. I would give it a one. This is probably the worst song we've ever heard. We probably lost a subscriber. I love you, Paul. I do. I just think this song was terrible. I did like the guitar solo. The only reason I'm giving it a two instead of the one is because I did think that the dancey,
the happy
was contrasted with the horribleness of the Faustian message of the song. So there's that.
Oh my gosh.
Sori's just going to make sure that when or if she ever sells her soul to the devil, that she'll be clothed.
I'll bring my robe.
Yeah, you'll bring your robe. Yeah, yeah. So it's a two for me. What do you got?
I already gave it a two.
You already gave it a two. What did you give it a two for? How did it earn 2 points from you?
You're just the happy sound of it.
Because you imagined the guy with clothes on when he was singing the song.
Picture people in a coffin. You know what I pictured? People
were
in a
coffin.
Yes, I know. But I just couldn't understand why we were talking about that when the music was so different. I just pictured a couple of friends driving around in the car. Everybody's having fun. And then before I know it, people are selling their souls without their clothes on.
Naked. In a coffin. See, again, the coffin thing didn't make it. All it was the clothes. The clothes are very important to Sori. Very important to her.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah. She takes a shower with clothes on. Unbelievable.
Don't tell them that.
This is our community. You need help. You need prayer. All right, guys. Well, there's that. So it's now 1:19 in the morning. I think she's just punch drunk because we've been working a lot trying to get this stuff to you beautiful people.
Yeah, I know. My mood switched.
Yeah, you did.
Because
you were all angry. Well, that's the thing. And then Shaitan showed up and now you're all happy. Ridiculous.
Well, seeing your reactions to this
stuff
is always entertaining.
I'm going to watch this video again because it's going to be like...
You know, I want to just watch you.
And I'm like, these are world leaders who are planning terrible things to do to us. They started the Iraq war, blah, blah, blah. You're like, that's shameful. I'm like, that's right, babe. It is shameful. How could they do that? Abuse their power like that. They didn't have clothes.
There's an extra shirt here for them.
It's an extra shirt. So if you have... Speaking of which, we will be... No, it's too early.
Yo, chill. All right. End this video so we need can to send end it this out.
Video. Okay, okay. Vin out.
Sorry out.
This is a two. You're getting a two. Yeah, actually, no. Vin out.
Sorry out.
Yeah, two. All right? You're a terrible band. Terrible band.
Oh, my gosh.
Unbelievable.